Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Vanessa, and usually I do a whole bunch of cleaning videos for you guys with some random stuff sprinkled in here and there, and this is one of those randoms. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how I make my soy candles. So this is my take. This is step-by-step how I make it. So let's go ahead and move to the stove, and I'll show you guys how to make soy candles.
Okay, just kidding. We're not starting on the stove, but we are starting with measuring out some soy wax. Now I get the 4-6-4, and right now what's gonna happen is I accidentally left this outside too long, so it melted together. Usually it comes in like flakes and stuff, and I can easily scoop it up with a spaghetti, like an old spaghetti jar, marinara sauce jar. That's usually what I use, but since this is all happening, what I'm gonna have to do is I have these like chisel things kind of for like woodworking or, you know, whatever, because I also make melts and there's harder wax. So what I ended up doing was I grabbed one of those little woodworking tools and I started kind of moving it around and just kind of doing it by hand. Usually I don't do it like this. Of course, when I want to film a video, this is what it does, but usually it's not like this. So usually you could just scoop it up. And I do about 2 pounds whenever I am doing candles. A little over is fine. Usually 2 pounds for me is about 4 9-ounce jars and then a 6-ounce jar. So that's where I usually am at. If you go more or less, you know, it may vary on what you can actually fill up. And then I have this pot. And if you see all the white residue at the bottom, we have very hard water here in Arizona. So I heat up the water, I make sure it's hot, and then I'm gonna throw it onto the stove. And really quick before I meant to mention this, if you are doing candles and you're measuring out and it doesn't give you the option for pounds, then do 16 ounces, or in my case, it would be 32 ounces. And then once I throw this onto the stove, I'm gonna throw in the big jar of it, or the melter. I don't really know what these are called. And I'm going to turn it on to high. And the only reason I'm doing that is because I'm just trying to get it to the temperature that it needs to be. Usually I do it at about 185. Right now I don't really do it anymore where I am putting a thermometer in. And the only reason why is because I've learned my stove and the heat and the temperatures and all of that stuff. So I know that the moment it melts, I have about maybe 3 minutes and then I take it off right away, because it's a consistent. It will always be, once it is completely melted, it's 3 minutes. But for beginners, I definitely recommend a thermometer. Make sure it's at 185. You want the wax to open up and allow the fragrances and stuff to get in. Now I'm going to color mine today. They're not just going to be pure white, and I'm going to use seafoam green because we are going to be doing a mint eucalyptus type of fragrance. Now I don't throw in the dye block until all the wax is completely melted, because I don't want to lose the wax if it's not melted, because then it will throw off the temperature. So just make sure that the wax is completely melted before you throw in the dye block. Wow, I can't talk today. But yeah, just make sure the wax is just completely melted. If you're doing liquid dye, you could do it at any point. Honestly, usually what I do for liquid dye is I wait until the, like, right before I'm about to add my fragrance oil, and then I add it in. But when it's the blocks, I like to put it on the stove because it just melts way easier. And then for fragrance oil, I add 2 ounces per pound. So per 16 ounces, 2 ounces. If that makes sense. So right now, since I'm making a mixture, it'll be 2 and 2. I'll have to do a video more in depth on how to mix fragrance oils, but that's what I'm doing at this point. I'm doing 4 ounces per 2 pounds. And then I usually mix that in when the temperature is at about 140. Because I don't want it to get too hot. I don't want the fragrance oil to be just sitting in a hot oil. Then it's going to burn off, and then you're not going to get as strong of a smell. The one thing I pride myself in is having a very, very strong candle. So I refuse to let anything ruin that. So try to pour it in a little bit later. The cooler it is, the better it is. But you also want it to bind to the oil, or I'm sorry, to the wax. So try not to put it in when it's too cold either. Like I said, I usually do about 140. If I could touch the bottom of the melter, which do not touch it when it's hot. When I know it's getting cool enough, and that, I mean, it takes forever for it to get cool. It takes about an hour with soy wax to cool down. So I'll touch it at about like 45 minutes and then I'll throw it in. But if you're using a thermometer, 140. And then I'm going to add the, we're gonna start getting the jars ready. Oh, and I'm sorry, I also forgot to mention that when I take it off the stove, I just stir it. And I mean, I stir it for like a good 5 minutes, and then I keep coming back to it and stirring for 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. And then when I put in the oil, I will stir it for about a good minute and a half to 2 minutes. And then, so here we are getting the jars ready. I put a wick holder in. This is the one that I use. There's many other ones that you can use, but I actually find these very easy and they're cheap. So whichever one that you would like to use, this is what I use. And then I just make sure that the wick and stuff is centered or as best as I can. And then I set them all up. And like I said, usually it's about 4 9-ounce candles and then 1 6-ounce. Now here, if I had under poured it for whatever reason, then I'll just hold off and I'll keep it around. And then when I'm gonna go back and do that candle, I'll bring that one back out. That way I'm not, you know, wasting any other jars or tins or whatever. So this one I didn't finish, and we're gonna add to that one today. Now, usually when I pour kind of cool. it is kind of cold. I will do it right as it's starting to like crystallize or get like milky. And it's kind of hard to tell when you are doing colored ones, because majority of my candles are colored. So it's a little hard to see it, but I will do it as it starts to get thick. Now, I do not always have the easiest pours. I do not have the cleanest pours. For some reason, this batch turned out beautiful today, but usually no. So at this point I'm pouring it, and you pour kind of slow because you don't want a lot of holes or, you know, crevices, because sometimes they will do that. It's just the wax is melting too quick, and there's still bubbles and air bubbles that are trying to get out, and then they get caught while the wax is cooling. So just try to do it cold, or as cool as you can, not cold. You don't want it to completely cool down on you when you're trying to pour. I do have a video coming, I think, where I'm going to show you guys how to fix candles in multiple ways, because I struggled with it in the beginning and I would like to help a bunch of you. But if you guys would like a video on how to fix candles if the pours are not perfect, please let me know down below. I'm so willing to do that video, because it is such a pain when you are busting your butt trying to make these perfect candles and then you end up getting a bunch of holes and the whole thing is all messed up and you don't want to sell it like that. So yeah. But then about an hour later, here they are cooled. You'll see some of them, there's a little drip line running down. I'll fix that later. And yeah, usually I leave these in, the wick holders and everything, overnight. That way, just in case I don't want to move anything and then have the wick get all messed up or, you know, whatever. But usually I'll leave it. But I don't have any jars that are done right now with the mint eucalyptus, so I will show you these jars, which is my fall scents. And they're capped and ready to go, and usually I'll set them up at the farmers markets. And you see that one right there? If you guys want to know how to fix that, I can show you.
And that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you liked it, please give me a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you guys haven't already. And let me know how you like this video. I'm thinking of doing like a whole series, and like one like how to fix candles and so on and so forth. I have a few of them in my mind, but I have a feeling that I'm missing some. So if there's anything that you guys want to know about candles and the whole shebang, yeah, let me know down below. But that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.